Hello everyone, welcome back. In today's video we are going to discuss about one more data structure by name B-tree as well as B-place tree. So to start off, let us define what do you mean by a B-tree first, and then we'll see how to perform the insertion operation or how to create the B-tree, and what is the advantage of B-tree over the traditional trees like over the traditional trees like something like a binary tree or a binary search tree or even the AVL tree. So coming to the definition of an B-tree, so first point to be noted is B-tree is a multi-way search tree. Hope all of you are familiar with the word, what do you mean by a search tree with respect to a tree. That in case of search tree, all the keys which are greater than the information stored in a node will be to the right side, and all the keys that will be lesser to the information stored in a node will be towards to the left of the node. So the property that holds goods for binary search tree will also be there for a B-tree. Note that B-tree has to have the property of that search tree. The second point about the B-tree is B-tree is a strictly balanced binary tree. Rather than calling it as a strictly balanced binary tree, I can say that it is a strictly balanced tree. In my earlier video, we have discussed about one more data structure by name AVL, wherein I have told that AVL is a balanced binary search tree. That was, if you see the structure of an AVL tree, I can consider this as the structure of an AVL tree. What we do to check whether it is an AVL tree or not, we check whether what is the balance factor of each of the node. So balance factor of all these leaf nodes are 0. Balance factor of this node is the height of left subtree and height of right subtree, that is 1 minus 1, that is 0. And balance factor of this node, that is the root node, it is height of the left subtree is 2 and height of right subtree is 1, that is 2 minus 1 is 1. So we have defined AVL tree as an balanced tree wherein the balance factor of each node can either be 0, plus 1 or minus 1. Here if you see, in order to traverse this leaf node, I need two edges. But even in case of this particular node also, from the root node, I use two edges to come to this particular node. But whereas this node, I need only one edge. That is, it is almost the height, that means here, the, what I can say, to perform any operation on this particular tree, in worst case, I require a time of log n in worst case. If you see here, I just need only one edge is sufficient, but whereas here I need two edges. But whereas in case of a B-tree, all the leaf nodes will be at the same level. But whereas in case of an AVL tree, here you can observe that all leaf nodes are not in the same level. Two leaves are there at level 2 and one leaf node is there at level 1. So I can say that AVL tree is not a strictly balanced tree. It is an almost balanced binary tree, but whereas in case of an B-tree, I can say that B-tree is a strictly balanced tree. In the sense, all leaf nodes all leaf nodes will be at the same level. Now the meaning of, okay, as I told in the my first point, that B-tree is a multi-way search tree. Here I can say that, okay, it is a M-way search tree, wherein this M, B, denotes the order of the tree. In the sense, in a B tree, if M denotes the order of a tree, a B tree can have max of M children's, and each node can store or I can say can hold up to max of M minus 1 keys. Please note that this is very important with respect to a B tree. In case of a B tree, if the order of the tree is denoted with M, then each node in a B tree can have max of M children's. It can have max of M children's, and it can store up to max of M minus 1 keys in each of the node. Say for example, if M is 2 means it is nothing but a binary search tree. It is a binary search tree. So it can have max of 2 children. So this would be a structure something like this. 10, 5, 25, 2, 8, 15 and 40. So here you see, I say that order of my B tree is 2. If order of my B tree is 2, each node can have max of M children. So here M value is 2. So each node is having max of 2 children. And in each of the node, I can store up to M minus 1 keys. M value is 2. So 2 minus 1 is 1. So in each node, I can store 1 key. So if the same thing, if I consider that M is equal to 3, then it implies that each node can have max of how many children? It can have max of 3 children. It can have max of 3 children because it depends upon the order of the tree. And each node can store a max of M minus 1 keys. So if I take this root node, let me assume that root node is having 2 keys, 10 and 40. Now, if there are 2 keys, then it will have 3 children. It will have 3 children. So in my left, in this, I can store up to max of 2 keys. So I can store 5 and 8. 5, because it needs to have the search property. So therefore any values less than 10 can be on the left side, and when any value greater than 40 will be on the right, to the right side of 40. So I can have 50 and 60. I can't have 3 keys, 50, 60 and 70, because the maximum number of keys that I can store is M minus 1, so 2 keys. So here either I can have 2 keys or I can have just 1 key. Even here also 1 key is possible, there is no problem. Here I can store 25. So this is a B tree. Please note that in a B tree, all leaf nodes are at same level. Leaf node are at level 1. Here leaf nodes are at level 2. This is one of the important property in case of a B tree as well as a B plus tree. All leaf nodes should be there at the same level. We'll take a small example how to construct a B tree, and then we'll take the same example and explain how to construct a B plus tree. Let's construct a B tree of order 3, of order 3 for the keys. I'll take randomly some keys, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 10, 20, 30 and 40. Now what is the value of M? In this case, M value is 3. So if M value is 3, if order is 3, then each node can have max of how many children? Each node can have max of 3 children, not more than that. And how many keys can be stored? Each node can store, each node, this is the first thing. Second thing is each node can store M minus 1, that is 3 minus 1 is equal to 2 keys. Each node can store max of 2 keys. Now let's construct the B tree for this. First is 50. I'll put this into a node, no problem. Next, I'll put 60. So 60 is greater than 50, so it has to be on the right side. Now my B plus tree has two nodes, 50 and 60. Please check whether this is allowed. Okay, I can, each a node can have two keys. It is allowed. Next, 70. So 50, 60. Now if I put 70 here, then this is a violation. Because it can't store 3 keys, it can store max of 2 keys. So what we need to do in this particular case, promote the middle one as the parent. So you promote the 60 as parent, so this becomes 60, 50, 70. Leave at each step, note that all leaf nodes should be at the same level. Now in this case there are 2 leaf nodes, 50 and 70, which are at level 1. So it is fine. Next one. Next is 80. So I need to insert 80 onto this tree. Note that, okay, 80 has to be inserted onto leaf node. So where is the position of 80? 80 can be inserted to the right side of 70. It is allowed because a node can hold up to max of 2 keys. So if I insert 80, my tree looks something like this. 60, 50, 70, 80. 2 keys are there. This is fine. Next is 90. Next, I need to insert 90. So, where can I insert 90? 90 has to be inserted as leaf node. So, 90 will occupy to the right side of 80. So, this will be 60, 50, 70, 80, 90. Is this possible? No, because a node can hold max of 2 keys. Now in this particular case, what you need to do, you need to promote this middle one as parent. So this becomes parent. So what happens is in root node, now you will have 60 and 80. 60 and 80. If there are 2 keys in the root node, then you should have 3 children. So first child, second child, third child. So to the left side of 60, there is 50. Retain as it is, no problem. So next, I am left out with 70 and 90. 90 you can attach here. No problem. 70 is greater than 60 but less than 80, it has to be in the middle. So this is the position of 80. Once you insert 80, after inserting 80, this leaf node will have 3 keys. So the middle one is promoted as to the parent node. Next one. So what is my next node? Next node is... next node is 10. So where is the position of 10? Okay, it is here. Compare 10 with root node. Left key is 60. It has to be on the left side. So after inserting 10, it is 60, 10, 50, 70, 90. Done. This is a B tree. Because all the leaf nodes are there at the same level. Next, after 10. Next node is 20. Where the, sorry, I think I missed 80 here. Next, I need to insert 20. Whatever is the position of 20, 20 is at the, it has to be at this node. So this is 60, 80, middle is 70, to the right it is 90, to the left side of 60 it is 10, 20 and 50. But this is not possible. A key, a node can hold max of 2 keys. So what you need to do, you need to promote the middle one as the parent. So 20 will be promoted here. Okay, after promoting 20 here, this root node will have 20, 60 and 80. It will have 20, 60 and 80. So out of 20, 60 and 80, 20, 60 and 80, 60 needs to be promoted further. So this is 60. To the right side you have 80. To the left side you had 20. Because 20 was promoted here, so it will be stored in the root node. 20, 60, 80. 60 is promoted. Now it is 20 and 80. Now to the left side of 80, I need to have 70. To the right side of 80, I need to have 90. To the left side of 20, I need to have 10. And to the right side of 20, I need to have 50. This is the tree after inserting 20. Now let us insert 30. Where 30 needs to be inserted, compare with 60, less, compare with 20, greater. So 30 will be to the will be in the in this particular node where 50 is stored. So it is 60, 20, 80, 70, 90, 10, 30 and 50. Done. Now coming to the last key. Last key is 40. Where is the position of 40? 40 is compared first. It's 40 with 60, less, compare 40 with 20, greater. So it has to be at this leaf. 60, 20, 80, 70, 90, 10, 30, 40, 50. But this is not possible. According to the definition, it says that a node can have max of m minus 1 keys. There are 3 keys here. So the middle one has to be promoted. So this is 60. The right child, the right subtree will remain as it is. Here what happens, if you promote the middle one to parent, then here the parent node will have now 20 and 40. So to the left side I have 10. 30 will be this. Greater than 20 but less than 40, and 50 will be right. So this is a B plus tree. If you note that all leaf nodes are at the same level. Hope this is clear. This is about a B tree. Let's quickly go for the other data structure by name B plus tree. B plus tree is almost similar to that of B tree, but only difference is in case of B plus tree, all the keys have to be present at the leaf node. Here if you see, in case of a B tree, at leaf I have the keys as 10, 20, 50, 70 and 90. And the non-leaf node contain keys 60, 20, 40 and 80. But whereas in case of a B plus tree, while constructing a tree, I should create a tree in such a fashion that all the leaf nodes, that is all the keys, have to be present at the same level. That means at the last level, I should have all my keys. I will take the same example. But I will construct a B plus tree for this. First node is 50, no problem. Next is 50, 60. Here also, okay, M value is 3, order is 3. Max number of children can be 3. And each key can hold m minus 1. That is, each node can hold two keys. This is also fine. Next, 50, 60, 70. This is not possible. Therefore, promote this one. This becomes 60, 70, 50. Now, till here, it is same as compared to B tree. Now, whenever I promote the middle one as a parent, in the sense whenever I am splitting, then this promoted key should be present even in the leaf. What we can do is we can store the promoted key either on the left node or on the right node. Now, in this example, we'll make sure that while promoting, I will store it on the left side. So, after promoting the 60 have to be present here also. So after three keys, my B plus tree looks something like this. So what I told, in case of B plus tree, all the keys should be there in the same level. It should be there in the last level. If you consider this, this is my last level of my tree. So in the last level, I have all the keys. For 50, 60 as well as 70. Now after inserting 80, even 80 should be there in the last level. So where to insert 80? 80 can be inserted, compare 80 with 60 greater. So 80 can be to the right side of 70. So 60, 60. So after inserting 4 keys, all 4 keys are there at the last level. Now, next is 90. So, where is the position of 90? Compare 90 with 60. You have to be on the right side. So, here. So, it is 60, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. But this is not allowed, because it can store a max of 2 keys. Now, promote the middle one. As parent. Now what happens here? It is 60, 80. To the left side, I have 50, 60. Now to the right side of 80 is 90, no problem. Middle one, is here. So I need to have 70. First one is 70. Along with 70, I need to have, if I am promoting 80, and I have stored to the left side, even 80 needs to be stored here. So after inserting 5 keys, 50, 60, 70, 80 and 90, all these 5 keys are in the last level. Hence it is a B plus tree. Next, there are some more keys left out. We need to insert them. I need to insert 10. Where is the position of 10? Compare 10 with 60. It is less, so it has to be on this side. So this is 60, 80, 90, 70, 80. This will be 10, 50, 60. Is this possible? No. It can't, has to have more than 2 keys. So now promote the middle one. So if you promote this, 50 will go here. Now it will be 50, 60, 80. Now even this root node after promoting, it will have 3 keys, 50, 60 and 80. Now you need to promote the, it is 50, 60 and 80, promote 60 as a parent. So 60, 80. This was 50, 60, 80. So 50 needs to be on this side. Left side, it is 10. Now 50 was promoted, so 50 has to be here. Next, to the right side of 50, if you clearly see, 10, 50, to the right side of 50, there was 60, to the right side of 80, 90 was, to the right side of 90 was there. To the left side of 80, I am left out with 70. So 70 will be here, but along with 70, I need to store even 80. So actually it is 60, 50, 80, 10, 60 and 90. As 50 is promoted, I am having a copy of 50 in this node. As I have promoted 80, a copy of 80 is there in this node. As well as 60 is promoted, 60 is present in this node. So this is fine. So after inserting 6 element, 6 keys, all 6 keys are there in my leaf. Next is 20. Where is the position of 20? 20 once again have to be present. Okay. Compare 20 with 60 less, compare 20 with 50 less, it is at this position. So 60, 50, 80, 90. Please, one more thing, note that this 50 and 80 are the internal nodes. No need for the internal nodes to maintain the copy. A copy should be always there in the leaf nodes. Hence, I am having the 60 in the leaf node. I am not having 60 as a part of this node 50. Now 60, this is a 10, what was my name, the node, it was 20, 10, 20 and 50. Now in this case, promote 20, so this is 60, right side remains as it is, 80, 90, 70, 80. Here, this will be 20, 50. So, this side to the left, I need to have 10 and 20 was promoted. So, 10 and 20 in the middle. I need, to the right side of 50, there is 60. In the middle, if there are two keys, I need to have three children. Here, a copy of nothing, a copy that are 50. So after inserting 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all 7 keys are there in the last level. Now let's go for the next key. Next key is 30. Where is the position of 30? So compare 30 with 60, less, compare 30 with 20 and 50. So it is greater than 20 and less than 50. So it has to be at this position. 60. Right side remains unchanged. So 30, 50 and 60. So all my keys are there in the last level. And finally, I should go for the last node. The last key is 40. I should, where I can insert 40, compare with 60 less, compare with 20 and 40, it has to be in the middle. So this is 60, 80, 90, 70, 80. Now this is 40. So this is 20, 50, 10, 20, right 60, the middle one, I need to have 3, that is 30, 30, 40 and 50. Now promote this here. On promoting this node will have 20, 40, 50. It will have 20, 40, 50. Now in 20, 40, 50, once again, 40 will be promoted. So 40 will go here. So it is 40, 60. Why it contains 40 comma 60? Because note that, okay, there are three keys here. The middle one will be promoted. Now in this node will have 20, 40 and 50. So the middle one once again is 40, 40 gets promoted. So note that the right subtree here, the right subtree, there will be no change. So this is 80, 90, 70 and 80. Only changes, okay, this part. So to the, this was a 20, 40, this was a 20, 40, 50. So this got splitted into 20 and 50. So this will be 20 and 50. So please note 50 to the left side of 50, 50 is there. And to the right side of 50, 60 is there. Now to the left side of 20, as it is 10, 20. 10, 20. To the right side of 20, to the right side of 20, I need to have 30. And note that, okay, this 40 is being promoted. And 40 is promoted, this got splitted. And 40 is at this position. 40 is at this position. Please note that I need to have this 40. This 40 also. So, occupies this. So, after inserting, how many? 10, 9 keys. All 9 keys. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 are there. So this is a B plus tree. And one more additional thing in case of a B plus tree is each leaf node, that means a reference will be there from one node to the other node at the last level to have a sequential access. Maybe primary thing is we'll try to understand what is the objective of using a P tree and a B plus tree. So before that, okay, please make sure that once the tree is being connected, a B plus tree is constructed, main thing that should be observed is all the keys that should be there in the leaf nodes, and all leaf nodes are connected with a pointer. That is, the first node connects to second node connects to third connects to fourth node, fourth to fifth, and finally from fifth to sixth. So this is about a B plus tree. Now coming to the objective of using B and B plus tree is, generally assume that this is my secondary storage, this is my secondary storage wherein my entire data is stored on my system. Now as we know that in case of a secondary storage, huge amount of data will be stored. For this data stored in the secondary storage, I need to build an index table. Let me assume that this is an index table. And this index table will be having a reference to the actual data. Now, to build this index table, we preferably use the data structure B and B plus tree. Please note that the objective of B tree and B plus tree is for providing indexing for data, or like for database. So this is the main objective of using B tree and B plus tree. As I told earlier, okay, the difference between the B and B plus tree, let us summarize. What is the difference between a B tree and a B plus tree? First thing that you have observed is all keys are there in the leaf. In case of a B plus tree, all keys will be in leaf nodes. But whereas in case of a B tree, all keys will not be in leaf nodes. Second point is, in case of B plus tree, as you saw, that all leaf nodes will be interconnected at the last level. So it provides both the sequential access as well as the random access. But whereas in case of B tree, all as all keys are not stored in the last level, it provides only random access. Third point, in case of a B plus tree, whenever we are promoting the middle element or the middle key as a parent, the copy has to be stored either on the left or on the right. Maybe in my procedure, I was storing all my promoted keys on the left side. So to store the promoted keys in any of the node, we need extra memory. So in case of B plus tree, additional memory is required to store the promoted key, but whereas in case of B tree, no additional memory is required. So these are some of the major differences between a B tree and a B plus tree. Hope in the concept of DBMS, that is the database management system, you will be made very clear the concept of both B tree as well as B plus tree, how to use B and B plus tree to do indexing for the database. Hope anyway the basic information about B and B tree and B plus tree are clear. Thank you.